Hi everyone, Nathan Stein, PIX4D. Now today, the sun's shining, we have the snow melting here behind me. You can see the field boundaries behind me here. You can see how muddy it is. I have my knee-high boots on, and it's kind of a messy day out here on the farm. Now, the season ahead, we're gonna start planting and spraying, and the new technology that's emerging out of the market requires very, very precise boundaries. The boundaries are used for turn-ons and turn-offs of clutches for planters, and electric planters are no exception. We have individual spray nozzle control that turns off as we drive across our waterways and terraces. We have all sorts of things like drones and robots that are starting to enter the scene on the farm, and all of those things need very precise boundaries. And what we have today and have been using in the past is ATVs and side-by-side four-wheelers and other things with an RTK mounted on it, as well as another device, which we pay for those two pieces of equipment, as well as the four-wheeler, the gas, and the person to drive around this field and the many fields that are in here, and to map the obstacles and other things with an RTK signal. And that's a very good way to do it, and it's worked very well for many of us in the past, and some of us still use those services today. However, I'm going to teach today how you can use PIX4D fields and a drone with an RTK antenna to fly these fields here, to map them very, very quickly afterwards, and turn that RTK map that we just made into RTK boundaries and export those to our monitors, our devices, and our control panels that will monitor and run the devices, the robots, the planters, and the sprayers that we'll have in our future. Okay, so what equipment are we going to need to do an RTK map and make RTK boundaries? Well, you're going to need an RTK drone. And not all drones have RTK capabilities, and some of them are PPK, and others are using external cameras that may not get RTK signals, even though the drone has an RTK signal on it. So I really and highly encourage you to reach out to your manufacturer, to your dealer, look at the specifications and try to understand, are your images being tagged with RTK corrections? A good example here is the Mavic 3 Multispectral from DJI. It is a multispectral camera, of course, with an RGB sensor. But you can see there's an add-on antenna on top here, which will work just fine for tagging these images. I'm going to go ahead here and use a base network. The reason why I use a base network is because that same base network I'm using is then going to be used in the equipment that I use in the field, so that I make sure that I use the same exact source, so that all my boundaries match up, so that my equipments are using the same exact location wherever they are in the field, so that they are applying or turning on and off when they should. If you use different bases, such as a mobile base and a different network, sometimes it may not work out as well. If you have questions or thoughts about that, please, I encourage you to go to our community pages and ask those there or to our support staff. All right, it's time to make our boundary, and what I'm going to do is create a route. I'm going to select mapping, and then I'm going to drop the points around the field where I want our edges to be. And it's pretty easy. You just click, and then you stretch the field boundary to the corners of where you want it to fly. This may take a little bit of time, and it's kind of a rough thing to do. It doesn't exactly have to be perfect. It just has to encompass the outside edges of that field. You don't want to go too short with the edge of the field unless you have some sort of special obstruction or thing that you don't need to fly over, depending on what your airspace is. Okay, so now I've got my location on here. I have my field set, and I'm going to go ahead and change the name of it. That's what I'm doing. We're going to call it boundary. Okay, I'm going to select my camera, and as I said before, I want to just make sure that we're using the Mavic 3 camera, DJI Mavic RGB. That's going to give you just the camera. You're not going to collect too much data that you don't need. Then you're going to set your height and your GSD. Thank you. I'm going to go ahead and change my altitude to 395 for my airspace. Going to go ahead and fly at full speed, and we're going to go ahead and we can go into the advanced settings. I like to have mine set at 70% and 80% overlap. That gives us more than enough overlap. You can go lower on the side overlap if you wanted. Maybe 60, 65 would be fine too. And then you can set your margin here. Sometimes I like to just set this at 100. This just makes us fly a little bit past our boundaries, as you can see, and that works out really well that way. Okay, so my drone is ready here. It's ready to take off. I've made sure that my RTK signal is connected, that I've been logged in. It says I have a good strong connection with 25 satellites here. I have my drone out, it's in the open view. I'm not underneath some the power lines that are right next to me here, so I'm staying away from them. And I don't have to calibrate with an RGB image, so that doesn't really matter. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take off and execute the mission.
Moving to start point. Home point updated.
All right, the mission just finished. The drone's coming home, and we're gonna go ahead and land. Okay, so we're ready here at the edge of the field, and I've taken my micro SD card out, put it in my computer and copied the files across so I can process a little bit quicker. I've opened PIX4Dfields and I'm about ready to import my project in. So I click import, I select the folder and I navigate where I've put that folder at and select the images. Now it's going to bring up a dialog here that's going to ask you whether you want to do fast or accurate processing. As I stated before, accurate processing is the very best that you can run. And it's going to do a good job with topography and 3D geometries in the field for those types of boundaries, especially in areas where the ground's changes quite often in different areas. If you're in a flat area and you just want to go quickly, you could do fast. Just be aware that it may be a little less accurate than the accurate processing, but it still will be much better because of its RTK accuracy. So I'm going to click on fast here for the sake of being at the edge of the field, and I'm going to click apply and click start processing. To give you a little background on my setup here, I do suggest using a mouse in this process. It makes it a lot easier to zoom and click. Using a touchpad can work, but it's not as easy and as quick. So if you really want the process to go fast, I suggest having a mouse and a nice mouse pad that works really well in the back of a pickup truck. So to start, we're gonna go ahead and click on the boundaries and then click a new boundary up there on the top left. We zoom in and we can start dropping points along this boundary. The snow banks make it a little bit harder, so you need to kind of slow down and make sure you're careful where you select. And we sped this up so that we can get around the field a little faster. Now, as you're clicking around the field, you just want to take care to zoom in and look at where the rows are, where the grass starts. And once you've completed it, you click the check mark, and then we can add another shape. We've added another shape now. We're going to go around and draw this little field. While looking at the rows, you can kind of move around and pan. You just drag and click and drop those points as you go. It's nice to use a scroll mouse because you can zoom in and zoom out really easily. And I would like to note here, when you're in an area with heavy shadows, it takes a little bit longer to discern where those boundaries are, or you might want to choose a different time to fly during the day on certain fields. Now we're going to go ahead and add a cutout. That's the left button there. We can make a hole in this by just clicking the areas that we want to cut out, and you can see where it's X'd out, and then click the check mark. That works really well for our waterways and some sort of obstacles that are in our field that we want to remove, such as terraces and even power lines. Now, if you do mess up, don't worry. You can go ahead and drag those points into each other until they turn red, and it'll delete them. I normally roughly draw these fields, especially when they have curves in them, fairly roughly, and then I come back and I hit the plus button in between the nodes to add finer detail, and it makes it a lot easier and faster to, you know, fine-tune that adjustment. Now we're just finishing this one up. Once we're done, we hit the check mark, we name it, and then we go ahead and click export. We click the boundaries, and that will give us the option to export as a GeoJSON, KML, or shapefile. The shapefile is also compatible with the John Deere exports. So that's all I have for this project. If you have any questions, please go to our community page. You can go to the agriculture section and ask your questions there. If you have problems along the way, make sure to reach out to our support team. And as always, make sure to go to our website at pix4d.com. Download your free trial, 15 days, of pix4d fields, and try it out on your boundaries and on your fields. Thank you.